All right, so we're headed to Djenne, where the great mosque is, the mosque that Mansa Musa built. So we're about to catch the ferry. I'm going to give you all the highlights. My guide, he's right here on the ferry already. He's on his motorcycle, which is going to be our method of transportation around Djenne. So looking forward to it. I haven't been here in the last... When was I here last? 2013? It's been like 4 years. It's been like 3-4 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. So I haven't been here 3-4 years. So this is our guide.
My name is Lasina. So everybody in Djenne call me historian.
I'm historian guide. There we go.
Yeah, I'm English teacher in the secondary school in Djenne.
Good, good.
Yeah.
Good.
Happy to see you, man.
So is this the Niger River?
Bani, this is Bani.
Bani River,
it's
okay.
Because in Mali we have got two rivers, Nangere and the Bani. So that one is Ninger.
Okay.
Bani also.
Okay.
So Bani means in our language the small river.
Okay.
And the Ninger means the big one.
Okay.
If you want to enjoy the Ninger River, you must do 45 kilometers from here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we're going to Mopti when we leave here, so I know Mopti.
Course. If you arrive in Mopti, you can see the...
The river.
Conflict, yeah, of course. Ninger and the Banido.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but here is one village from Djenne, 4 kilometers from Djenne.
Okay.
Yeah, Sanuna. The name of this village is Sanuna.
Cool, cool.
Sanuna. Happy to see you.
So, let's...
Yeah.
They should build a bridge.
Yeah.
Have they ever considered building a bridge?
Yeah. Inshallah. They are going to do that, I think.
Hope so. All right, headed to Djenne. We just arrived in Djenne. The ferry stopped right here. Everybody's unloading, and we're about to hop on the bike and head into the city. Go ahead. Sorry about that. So we're here in Djenne.
Do you know in Djenne, everywhere in each quarter, the people has got one place when they take rest. So here is the place for the old men.
Oh, okay.
Here. So they are sleeping and taking the rest.
Okay.
You see, and you have also this one is making the boat. For the fishermen.
Mm-hmm.
You have also one fisherman. He's making the fish net.
Okay.
Yeah. So do you know here is Djenne?
Yes.
So Djenne was built in 8th century by the Bozo.
Bozo, okay.
Yeah, so the Bozo are the fishermen.
Okay.
So the majority of people in the town here are Bozo.
Okay.
And then after Bozo, you have Fulani people, you have Bambara people also.
Uh-huh.
So today, Ghana has got 21 people who live in this area.
Okay.
21,000 people.
Wow.
Yeah, in Ghana.
Okay.
And we have got also 42 Quranic schools.
Okay.
42 Quranic schools.
Okay.
And 9 government schools.
Okay.
So it's also forbidden to build the house by cement in Ghana. Because Ghana was designated by all the heritage by UNESCO in 1990.
Let me ask you this. But since you guys are designated by UNESCO.
Yeah.
A historical place.
Yeah.
How does that benefit you guys? Do they give you money?
Anything for the town.
They give you anything you need?
Anything. Even if they give money, perhaps they give it to the government, not to the people in from the town here.
But do you guys see the money?
Yeah.
So you guys benefit from UNESCO
of course.
Destination. Okay.
Yeah. So it is where the town was designated by World Heritage by UNESCO in 1988.
Okay.
So it's where it's forbidden to build the house by cement.
Okay.
So all the houses you have here in Ghana are building by mud.
Okay.
And then after finish to build the house by mud,
uh-huh.
when it's raining, it's better before the raining season,
uh-huh.
everybody must repair the house.
Okay.
So how they are going to do to repair the house? So when the river is dry, the people try to go with the horse car, donkey car, near the river to get
okay.
mud.
Okay.
Then after finish to get mud, they can go to look for rice covering. So this is the rice covering.
Okay.
So they are going to mix this mud and the cow dung.
Okay.
Or to mix this mud for 20 days, the mud will be ferment. And
okay.
then they can take to put in the wall to repair the house every
okay.
year, one day for every year.
Okay.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So don't worry, take your time to take picture.
Okay.
I'm
yeah.
official here.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. absolutely. Jenny.
Jenny.
Okay, can I take a photo of him? Can you ask him if I take a photo?
So I think.
No? Okay. He said no.
Do you remember before that architecture?
Uh-huh.
Last year when you came here. So this is one of the oldest houses in the town here.
Okay.
This is where the first explorer French René Caillé was here before to go in Timbuktu.
Okay.
So now it become the housing for the traditional chief.
Okay, is he here? The
yeah,
chief? Where is
here.
He?
The chief.
Can I want to meet him? I want to meet him.
He's not here now.
Ah.
But here is the house. So this man is one of the brother of the chief in the village.
Okay.
Here also.
Hello.
Yeah.
Can you ask him when the chief is coming back? Can you ask him?
So, question mark.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
okay. Maybe we'll run into him as we walk
Inshallah.
Around. Maybe. Inshallah, yeah.
Inshallah.
I'd like to meet
but
him.
He's one of the oldest houses in the town here.
Okay.
Very nice architecture.
Uh-huh.
Which is Kulani Tukulor architecture.
What's it called?
Tukulor.
Tukulor.
Kulani Tukulor.
Tukulor, okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Hello.
Have you guys did anything new since the last time I was here?
Mm-hmm.
What have you guys done, like, new? Have you guys added anything since the last time I was here?
No.
No?
There's
okay.
There's not any new thing here.
Okay.
So everything are new here, you know.
Okay.
Some of you are old here, you know.
Okay.
Have you?
Can I take a photo? Hello, how are you?
So they are one of my students.
Really? Can I take a photo?
If you want, you
okay. That's right, you teach as well.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I'm teaching in the secondary school.
Here. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
Which is why everybody know me.
Uh-huh. Were you born and raised in Jenin?
Yes, I was born here.
Wow, and
my
raised.
My family is here, my wife, my children.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, before to finish the video, we go to see my family.
Okay.
Yeah.
When did your mom pass away? When did your mom pass away?
My mother.
Yeah.
My mother was born in Jenin also.
And when she passed away?
Yeah, because she has got malaria.
When?
Oh, you're 6 years
old. Oh, okay. I thought I met your mom for some reason. I don't know why.
Okay.
Hello. Salve.
Huh? Sir, Jenenki means our language.
Oh, okay.
He said, you must speak our language here.
I know. I'll learn. I know. I have to learn. Okay.
He's going to learn Jenenki.
So you guys don't speak Bambara here?
You speak Bambara.
Okay.
So do you know in Jono we speak Bambara.
Uh-huh.
We speak Fulani.
Uh-huh.
We speak Bozo.
Uh-huh.
In Jono here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So Bozo is our language here. But everybody in Mali speak Bambara.
Uh-huh.
It's like official language.
Okay.
We have the really small street, you know.
Yeah, what?
The very street.
Yeah, narrow streets. Yeah. So having a car is really not practical. You got to have a bike, motorcycle.
Okay, so you have the nice architecture here.
Okay.
Like that one. This one is calling Sudanese architect.
Sudanese, okay.
You know, before the independence, the Mali name was Sudan. Before the independence.
Really?
The Mali name was Sudan, and that is why you have the Sudanese architect.
Why is that? Why was Mali called Sudan?
Because is the name that the people have given to the area to call Sudan, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there's two Sudans.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Mali Sudan and Sudan for the South Sea Sudan also.
Okay.
So before and after independence, they call Mali.
Gosh.
But
okay.
Before the independence, it was Sudan.
Oh, okay.
So it is why you have the Sudanese architecture.
Okay.
So with the Sudanese architecture, you have four pillars. One pillar, two pillars, three pillars, and four.
Okay.
Pillars.
Yeah.
So that means the first pillar means the first wife in the family is the wife who can cook. Very well.
Right.
The second pillar means the second wife in the family is the wife who gives many babies.
Okay.
The third pillar means the third wife in the family is the wife who can take care to the stranger.
Okay.
And the last one means the last wife in the family, but she's like the queen in the family. She's also the chief in the house, darling.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
So this is the last pillar.
Okay. She's the queen mother.
Exactly. So when Geno was built in 873, the first brick that the people made to build the house, that was the round bricks. So it is why the people said, if Geno made that brick in 873, it's better to give it another name. So the people called that one Geneferi.
Okay.
Can you repeat?
Geneferi.
So that means brick made in Geno.
Okay.
And then in 12th century, the people are going to make another bricks. So that is rectangular bricks.
Okay.
Rectangular, so that one. So this is a rectangular bricks.
Okay.
In 12th century. Because before to make that one, you must use a mule, wood mule.
Mm-hmm.
So the mule which is using to make that is come from in Europa, bring by the Arab Berber.
Okay.
So that is why the people call that one Tubabuferi.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you repeat Tubabuferi?
Tubabuferi.
So now everybody like to use the Tubabuferi to build the house. They don't know how to use it again, the wall bricks.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was telling people it's very hot in Mali, but Mikhail was saying that this is considered cool because it's winter time. He was saying that this is considered cool because it's hot out here.
It's very hot.
Yeah, it's very hot, but he was saying this is considered cool. He said it gets hotter.
Hotter, yeah.
Yeah.
So, but it's cold now.
Right, but it's hot.
Yeah. It's cold, but it's high.
Yeah.
Know? So, because there is the river in the small water in the river.
Uh-huh.
So, when you come here after December, oh my God, it's going to be very hot again.
Oh my goodness. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's hot now. And he said, well, this is after cool. December. I'm like, no way. Yeah. Like, yeah, this is considered cool. I'm like, goodness.
But by night, it's very cold, you know.
Right, because like the desert, yeah. Because I know in Dogon country, it's hot during the day, then it's cool at night.
Exactly. So this is which we have come to see, Tubabuferi.
Okay.
Is the brick will come from in Europa.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So if the house is fell down, they are going to take the same mud to mix with water to make again a new one.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, everywhere you have the mud bricks. So that means there is one old house which is fell down here.
Okay.
It is why they are making a lot of
mud bricks. Yeah.
Sudanese architect of these four pillars.
Uh-huh.
Okay, here is the quarter which is calling the Moroccan's quarter.
Okay, what's it called?
Moroccan's quarter.
Moroccans.
Yeah, the Moroccan.
Okay, Moroccan. Yeah, okay, okay.
So the Moroccan were here in 16th century.
Uh-huh.
So they are not coming to fight or to colonize. They were here because there was the tradesmen, commerciant.
Uh-huh.
So they live with Morocco and uh-huh. they come to Tombouctou.
Uh-huh.
And when they arrive in Tombouctou, with a lot of camel.
Uh-huh.
When they arrive in Tombouctou with a lot of camel,
uh-huh.
they can leave a lot of camel there, and they take the boat uh-huh. and they to travel on the river Niger.
Uh-huh.
Before to live in Tombouctou, they can bring goma arabica
uh-huh.
and salt.
Okay.
So when they arrive here, they can change something by something. It was like battery. And then before to live in Geneva, they said it's better to let the memory in Geneva. Then after them, the people who will be in Geneva can see the Moroccan is influencing.
Mm-hmm.
So which kind of influence is the Moroccan's architecture, which is calling Moussa Arabia.
Okay.
So Moussa Arabia means in Arab, I can see you, but you cannot see me.
Okay.
Because before, the women Moroccan cannot go out.
Uh-huh.
But instead, only inside the house, they can open the windows to see the people who pass in the street.
Okay.
So that means Moussa Arabia.
Uh-huh.
And then before, if you come here also, if you want to know how many people live in Moroccan's house, so look at up the number of the people. You have 7 or 8 pillars with cement.
Okay.
So this is the number of the people
that live here.
The big one at the corner is the mother.
Uh-huh.
The small one is the children.
Okay.
So here also, that one is the father.
Okay.
That one is the father.
Okay.
And this place is empty. That means if you get a new baby, you must put one here in this place.
Okay.
So that is Moroccan architecture.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you understand?
I understand.
Madame, ça va bien? Félicitations. Merci à vous de me. So this is the engine for the millet and
okay.
the rice.
Okay.
The women bring the millet and the rice here and the Indian pound.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Madame, what with that? Overall. Ça va? Red bricks, so that one is not forbidden. After finish to build your house, you are free. If you have money, you can buy the red bricks.
Red bricks, okay. Area. Okay.
So this is the difference to know in the town who is rich man and who is poor man.
Okay.
So the people who use only mud to repair the house, that means they are not rich man in the town here.
Okay.
So everywhere they must repair again. So the people who you can see in the house, they have the red bricks.
Mm-hmm.
So that means they are not poor man here.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
So that is the difference to know who is rich and who is poor.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's considered rich in Jenne?
Hmm?
What's considered rich in Jenne? Like how
so
much
there
money?
There is no one rich one quarter that you can say. Which quarter is rich quarter? No.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So in each quarter is calling mixed quarter.
Okay.
Yeah, you can see the Bambara people, the Fulani people, the fishermen, Bozo people
okay.
in each quarter. So they are mixed together.
Okay.
So they are not very, very rich one, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. How are you?
Hey.
When are
you? How are you?
I'm fine. How are you? How are you?
And your family?
I'm fine. How are you?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Salam alaikum. On the way. Ça va? The boy told you, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
I mean, do you like Junior very well?
Huh?
You like Junior?
Yes, I told Mikhail that when I come back, I have to go back to Junior.
Okay, perhaps next year I'm going to look for one Fulani woman for you, and then you're going to
build... Oh, you're going to find me a Fulani wife? Oh, that'd be awesome. Find me a Fulani wife.
Fulani wife. Uh-huh. You like very well the Fulani woman.
I like Fulani. Yeah, Fulani people are very beautiful.
Very nice.
Very beautiful,
so
yeah.
So they have the tattoos here.
Right, not all of them do, though.
Yeah. They do in the town here because they said they're the beautiful girls. It is why they put the tattoos here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not all of them have it, though, the tattoo.
Tattoo?
Yeah, not I don't see all of them with it.
You don't see?
Well, I have tattoo, too. Look at all my tattoos.
This is good.
Look at all my tattoos. I got a ton of tattoos.
So the female women also have the tattoo here.
On the mouth, yeah.
Oui, madame? Opo radio yene ceregena aka jurin kawe barkala wonno be I don't know ne yoka alba fosiga ano ne
hello
allah ko ta ci tregen wonno be salam alaykum wonno be barkala ça va bien anche ça va kokay
hello All right, I gotta switch batteries real quick. Battery's going dead. How far are we from the mosque, the big mosque?
It's not far.
Okay.
We are going to make tour to go to see the mosque.
Oh, okay.
It's my job, you know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You cannot come in Jena, visit.
And not see the mosque.
Without you
seeing the mosque, yes.
Oh, this is terrible. Don't worry, Amir.
Okay.
Salam alaikum. Who brought you? One night, and
okay. Yeah, definitely don't want to fall down there.
Thank you.
That woman asked your name.
Dynast.
He's one of my aunt.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Bye bye. Everybody who see you, they told me the friend is very nice. What's his name? The friend is very nice.
Oh, really? I'm a nice guy. Everybody in Jenny thinks I'm a nice guy, which I am, by the way.
Everybody ask me for this question. Historian, what's his name, your friend? He's a very nice man. So it is why I said I'm going to look for one Fulani woman.
A wife for me, Fulani wife.
And then you are going to stay here. Yeah. When you go and you come back for the holiday, you have your wife.
Wife right here.
And house here. No problem.
Hello.
Said, oh, this man is very strong man. You know, you can become the mayor of Jenny.
Really, the mayor of Jenny?
Because all the people love you, you know.
So I should run for mayor of Jenny?
Yes, one day, inshallah.
One day, okay. Do I have to be a Mali citizen to run for mayor?
Yeah.
I do?
Yes, they have finished that.
Okay.
Yeah. So this election is finished.
Okay.
Perhaps next election, we are going to vote for you.
Vote for me? Okay, yeah. That'd be awesome. Mayor Jenny.
Today, over a corner, but for me. How are you today? Hey, okay.
How are you?
How are you?
She's one of my students also.
Okay, hello. So I'm here.
The cemetery for the baby. The baby, when the baby was born, when they had died. So here is the
cemetery. That's no good. Does that happen often?
Exactly.
When babies are born and die, it happens often?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Perhaps when the mother is pregnant, the mother can have malaria. The husband haven't money to take the mother in the hospital. And the baby has got also malaria.
That's no good.
So when the blood is finished, so you must die.
Well, that's not good. What is this?
Is it the tomb of the young girl who was being sacrificed in 8th century?
Young girl.
You know, in 8th century, it was very difficult to build a house in this island.
Okay.
When the people tried to build a house, one day, 2 days, the house fell down.
Oh, okay.
So the people are going to ask the teacher from Quranic school, why any time the house fell down? And the teacher from Quranic school, they are going to do before to build the house, it's better to give one sacrifice. And then that sacrifice will be a virgin girl. So they are going to take one nice girl, and she was 13 years old. They are going to burn life to protect the town in 8th century.
Wow.
And this history is not a legend story, it's a real story. So here was the tomb of the young girl.
Wow.
And the name of that girl is Tapama. Genepo. So that means the first deity in the town.
Okay, wow.
So now after finished to burn her in life, Gene was protected by devil. So Gene means devil is pleased.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the meaning of Gene. Okay. Devil is pleased.
Okay.
So after to give that girl like sacrifice, the town was protected.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Or we go back to see the mosque.
Okay. We'll take a photo.
Do you see something up?
I see the mosque.
Oh.
I see the mosque, the Grand Mosque. Hello. The meats.
Yeah, the meats. Good chairman.
Hello. How are you?
What? Natanal gonna who no gunaharu. Won't let you come over a quidu. Jack and Edo come over a quidu. Why are you fools?
This man, you remember with you, and then he asked me, this man is not coming in Guinea here? I said, of course, you were in Guinea here too.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Can I take a picture of him?
Okay.
Elka.
Is this where the market is?
Yeah, exactly, for the Monday market.
Uh-huh. So it'll be right here.
Matra, one of it. Spire, Sabian, Anke, Matra.
So here is the place for the big market. The
okay.
Market,
okay.
From here to there.
Okay.
And then you have also the small market. And that small market is uh-huh. not easy for everyday market.
Uh-huh.
It's calling also women market for the condiments.
Okay.
This is the small one here.
Okay.
So that one is the big. And they have the famous and the biggest mosque in South Africa by Mat.
Oh, man.
So
this is the mosque, Grand Mosque.
That mosque was built in 1906.
This is the...
1906.
This is the Mosque of Jenin?
Yeah.
Right here?
Yeah.
I thought Mansa Musa built it. I thought Mansa Musa built it.
In Jenin, we have got only one mosque.
Didn't Mansa Musa build this?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Of course.
Yes. Can we go inside or no?
Oh my God, inside it's not easy to go.
Oh, it's not? Okay, yeah. Okay.
They are going to ask a lot of money.
Oh, are they? Okay. And then, I went up there to take a picture, didn't I?
Yeah, in the roof.
Yes, let's do it again.
If you want
to. Yes, do it.
Uh-huh. We can pay the roof
mm-hmm.
and they go up.
So this is the Grand Mosque. Well, the Mosque of Jenin.
Yeah, there is only one mosque in all Jenin, is that one.
Okay.
And it becomes the famous one in the world by architecture.
Uh-huh. That's it, in all its glory. Yeah, I was right here and he took a picture of me.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a great view up here. I'm get another picture of it. One more shot of this.
Okay.
That's the Grand Mosque. This is the house that, the mosque that Mansa Musa built. There it is. In all its glory. All right, let's keep it pushing. So where are we headed now? To see your family?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. All right. Hello.
You know why that one carry this blue color? That means her husband is dying.
Oh, sorry.
So you know, Africa here, when you lost your husband, you must wear the blue clothes and to do 3 months inside the house.
Wow.
3 months you don't go out.
Wow.
So she's the president of the women cooperative.
Okay.
Hey, baby, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
How are you doing?
So she's the president of the women cooperative.
Okay, okay.
So there are 100 women who work in this association. They make my clothes and then they sell to the people.
Okay.
So if one woman have the problem, you can come to see the president, and she can give you money to do your clothes.
This us. That's after, us. Sage.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So the clothes is cotton.
Mm-hmm.
The clothes is cotton.
Mm-hmm.
They make the cotton with that one. So this is the color. The color is tree leaves.
Okay, so this is not sage.
And mud come from in the river.
They don't burn this.
Yeah, exactly, to make mud clothes.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. So she's also the mother of the children of Orphelina.
Okay.
Orphelina. She has got the children.
Oh, orphanage?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
She's one of the
girls. Okay. And these are the mud cloth.
You can put on your table.
Mm-hmm.
You can wear it. Oh. You can put in the wall to decorate your house.
Okay.
Yeah, you can wash also, no problem.
Mm-hmm.
This is the souvenir of Jenny.
I probably won't buy one, but I'll donate towards.
Uh-huh.
I'll donate towards the foundation or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I could donate something.
Okay.
Okay. Let's go to your house.
Okay.
Okay.
No problem.
But I'll donate something.
Yeah,
but I donate. Hello.
Daniel here is my family.
Okay.
Wife, children, brother.
Okay.
Aunt.
Okay.
She's my wife.
Hello.
Ça va bien?
Uh-huh. That's all I know. Outside of that, that's all I know.
No. Which you wanna come over, you know. We call culture ceremony.
Ça va bien? This is how we eat in Senegal.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
With our hands in Senegal.
Yes, Senegal also.
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is rice.
Yeah. Chebujin.
Chapchen, yeah.
Chapchen.
Yeah.
This your son?
Yeah, my son.
Okay. Their daughter?
Yeah.
Yeah, how many kids you have?
Yeah, I have 8 children.
8 children?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. It's a lot of kids.
Exactly. Uh-huh. I like to make one team.
Uh-huh. Yeah, one team.
Football team.
One football team. Yeah, yeah, you got the 3 boys. That's good. That's good. Okay. All right. And this is the river.
You know, in the 8th century, that was the all the money in the town.
Uh-huh.
In 8th century, the people used that one like money.
Like money?
In 8th century in the town here. The people use that like money. Everything you can buy with that one, it was like money.
So this is your shop?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, perfect. Do me a favor, tell everybody your name, where they can contact you.
Okay.
Well, hold on. Right. All right, go ahead.
Okay, so my name is Lassina. So, but everybody in general call me Historian.
Okay.
I'm English teacher in the secondary school in Geneva. If you want to find me, when you arrive here, you can ask me. Historian is my name.
Are you on Facebook?
Yes.
Okay, what's your Facebook?
My Facebook is Al-Husseini. Al-Husseini Sinanta. And they have a big clothes, white color.
Okay.
And they have one hat in on my head.
Is okay.
Is white color also.
Okay. So what's the name of again your Facebook? Say it one more time.
Al-Husseini.
Spell it out for the people.
Okay. A. L. H. O. E. D. S. A. E. N. E.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And what's your contact number, phone number?
My contact number is 7-6-1 3 9 8 5 8.
Okay.
I can repeat again. My contact number 7 6 1 3 9 8 5 8.
Alright, perfect. Okay, well, this concludes our tour of Jene. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Next, we're going to Mopti, and then after Mopti, we're going to Dogon Country. Dynasty Amir, till next time, I'm out.